Uh-oh, cup check. Before we talk about the calamity that this game was, this video is brought to you by Sports Interaction. Get in on Stanley Cup Finals action. Lightning versus Colorado. There might not be many games left with Sports Interaction, Canada's sportsbook. Before the game starts, live in-play or one of their many prop bets. Doing it right since 1997, Sports Interaction makes it easy to deposit, play, and cash out. Join now and see all the sports betting has to offer. Head to sportsinteraction.com/SDPN. That's sportsinteraction.com/SDPN. But it's 19 plus, and do me a favor, please play responsibly. Now, let's talk about that gong show. The Colorado Avalanche win 3-2 in overtime over the Tampa Bay Lightning in Game 4 of the 2022 Stanley Cup Final. They take a 3-1 series lead back home to Colorado, where on Friday night, the Stanley Cup will be in the building. Now, at the time I am shooting this video, it is 12:36 a.m. The day after, technically, that Colorado won, but within about an hour of Colorado winning. And the reason it took me so long to shoot this thing is, as I'm getting ready, I'm seeing the post-game quotes, I'm looking at the highlights, I'm going over numbers. John Cooper drops his post-game press conference. Now, I don't show a ton of these in my videos, but he said the goal shouldn't have counted. And you need to see his tone. You need to see what he said. Because I talking about the other four goals in this game feels like a moot point right now. We can only talk about the winner. So I'll show you that video in a second. Who scored the winner, by the way, Steve? Who scored the winner? Nazem Kadri, who is not with the team who drafted him. I don't know who it was. Kitchener? Was it? I think it was Kitchener. Ooh, ow, my heart. Here's what happened on the winner. First of all, it should be said, Nazem Kadri playing his first game of the Stanley Cup Final after getting something messed up in his right hand, so that would be his top hand on the left shooting Kadri, by that nasty hit in the third round from Evander Kane. It was an okay game. I thought he got better as the night went on. He had a great ace scoring chance in the first, missed the net by a mile. And I'm like, okay, I don't know how well he's gonna be able to shoot. Top hand, stick handling's definitely gonna be tough. So, in overtime, puck is cleared down into the Colorado Avalanche zone. That will be important. Bowen Byram, last man back, ahead of Darcy Kemper, who's the goalie, the real last man back. Darcy Kemper fires the puck up the boards to a guy who is notably not Mikko Lehtinen, Arturi Lehkonen. And it's funny, because I said on the broadcast, on the stream, on watch the Stanley Cup playoffs with Steve Dangle on the Sportsnet YouTube channel, I said, how many goalies have gotten an assist on an OT winner this season? The only one I can think of is, and this was regular season, 3-on-3, Mike Smith got one, I'm pretty sure. Here's Darcy Kemper touching the puck for the secondary assist, but it was a heck of a pass up to Arturi Lehkonen. Here's where Arturi Lehkonen makes his dart of a pass to Nazem Kadri, and here is where Nazem Kadri receives the thing. This is important. Look at this picture. Look at Naz. Look where he receives the puck. You see on the very, very right end of the screen, there's a Lightning defender here. You know what? Off the screen, there's another Lightning defender. Here, this is like a fraction of a second later. That's Ryan McDonough at the bottom of the screen and Mikhail Sergachev above him. Nazem Kadri with only a few feet to go between them. My bet's on McDonough and Sergachev. How did it go? Let's fast forward a second to see. Ooh, oops, that's not very good. Kadri goes by McDonough like he's standing still and goes by Sergachev, not much better, Mikhail, with a busted hand and everything. Takes the puck from his backhand, pulls it forehand, snipes it, no! Oh my goodness, Vasilevskiy's ridiculous. How did he make that save is what I thought when I was calling it in real time. And here's why I don't feel bad for thinking that that puck didn't go in real time. This is Nazem Kadri's reaction to the goal in real time. He didn't know it went in. But the proof is in the pudding, and the pudding is the top of the net. The puck gets lodged into the upper part of the net. Nazem Kadri won the game! Overtime winner in his first game back! His first game in a Stanley Cup Final ever! Heroics in overtime. And that brings us to now. Everything seems normal. Nothing seems untoward. This is just a run-of-the-mill OT winner. This is John Cooper speaking after the game.
They fought their way to to a third Stanley Cup final in a row. And in a cap era when it's so damn hard and the rules are put against you because the league wants parity. And I love that about the league. And that's what makes it tougher. And just watch this team, what they've gone through and the battling that's gone on. And we're all in this together, players, coaches, refs, everybody. But this one's going to sting much more than others just because I think it was taken on. It was potentially, I don't know. It's hard for me. This is going to be hard for me to speak. I'm going to have to speak. I'll speak with you tomorrow. You're going to see what I mean when you see the winning goal. And my heart breaks for the players because we probably still should be playing. I'll be available tomorrow.
All right. Picante. Yeah. So there's a lot going around. And mainly the argument seems to be that Cooper is mad because the Avalanche had too many men on the ice. The other theory that I've seen around is Bowen Byram high-sticked the puck on its way down into the Colorado zone. He high-sticked the puck. Play should have been blown dead when Kemper touches the thing. Now, I have thoughts on both of those things. The high stick, I don't think was terribly relevant to the outcome of the play. Kemper would have been the person to touch it anyway. I have more thoughts on the too many men on the ice call, but I think this is something that everyone is missing in this equation. If John Cooper really thinks that his team was robbed of a full game in the Stanley Cup Final, a game that if they had won it would have tied the series at 2, and now they're going at Colorado and they got to win 3 straight games. If John Cooper really thinks that injustice happened to his team, why is he being coy about it? Why? Oh, you're going to see tomorrow. What? I've never seen a coach throw a tease. What is this, Paradise Island? Wait, that's not the name of the show. What's the name of the show? What the hell is that show? No, Too Hot to Handle. What kind of reality show tactics? Dude, if there's a problem, a specific problem, speak up. Say it. Better yet, talk to someone who can actually change the outcome of the game. Now, I don't think you can review too many men on the ice, which you can review goalie interference, you can review offside, you can review high stick, you can review if the puck hit the mesh, but you can't review too many men. That seems like a flaw in the rules, so you probably should be able to review that. But if it's something that the ref could have fixed, you should have spoke it up, and maybe the reason he was so sheepish in the post-game scrum is he could have challenged or something, and he feels partially responsible because he didn't do it and let the team down. I don't know. None of us know because he didn't tell us, and it's weird that he didn't tell us. So let's start with, that's weird. So for the too many men argument, here is the screenshot in question. Now, there are a few different angles, but as you can see, there are 6 members of the Colorado Avalanche on the ice right now. Nathan MacKinnon being the guy who is stuck at the Avs bench. He's not on the Avs bench yet. So really, he's the 6th man. He's not a part of the play, but he's on the ice. So we can all acknowledge that there's 6 members of the Colorado Avalanche, not including the goalie. There's 6 skaters for the Avalanche on the ice right now. Okay? We can all acknowledge that. Take a look. Look close. Make sure. There's 6, right? There are. There's 6. All right. Now, if we take a closer look, there's also 7 Lightning skaters on the ice at the exact same time. And that kind of feels relevant. Kind of funny, to be honest. But then the paperwork. Oh, baby, the paperwork. Steven Ellis and Mike Stevens from the Hockey News with the sharp eyes on the game sheet. Even the OT winner on the initial game sheet printed out by the National Hockey League had 6 Colorado skaters on the ice. Byram, Eric Johnson, Valerie Nichushkin, Darcy Kemper, he doesn't count, Josh Manson, Arturi Lehkonen, and Nazem Kadri. Now, we already know that's wrong because Nathan MacKinnon was on the ice and he's not one of the six listed there, and there were only six Avs on the ice, so it's not like he was number seven. Mike Stevens then tweeted this. The NHL changed this on their website just now to five skaters. The initial game sheets are generated by the NHL's automated puck tracking. So this one has Byram, Eric Johnson, Valerie Nichushkin, Kemper, he doesn't count, Josh Manson, Arturi Lehkonen, and Nazem Kadri. It's still wrong! So that doesn't work. Then there's this very good exchange on Twitter between Lou Seed, who I'm not aware of, and Scouting the Refs, who I'm very aware of. Love that Twitter account. Highly recommended follow. This is a good point. Skaters 4 and 5, if you look at the screenshot here, are well into the play before Nathan MacKinnon gets to the bench. Being involved in the play is irrelevant in the rulebook. That said, the Avs were dominating OT, but still. So basically, we all know, watching hockey, there are many, many instances of there being more than five skaters on the ice, but it's usually for like a second or two. And the guy is usually, the guy coming on before the person who is coming off for him, the guy coming on is usually not that involved with the play. And when they get too involved with the play, we start going, oh, too many men. And if they touch the puck, well, that's when you actually get called for. But Scouting the Refs pointing out, not exactly. If number six is going off, he's within 5 inches of the bench and legal, provided he's not involved in the play. Now, funny enough, this isn't the first time that Colorado's been caught up in this, except it cost them before. If I'm not mistaken, did they not play St. Louis in 2019 when St. Louis ended up winning? There was a goal that was called back where Landeskog was offside, and technically speaking, he was. He hadn't cleared. My issue with this call, and the reason why I thought the goal should have stood, is he was literally just standing at the bench. And he didn't just get there, he had been there, and he was standing at the bench. He's waiting to get onto the bench. He is not part of the play. He's not part of the play. I thought the goal at the time should have counted. I understand why, under the rules, it didn't count, but we all know he's not part of the play. So, looking at Nathan MacKinnon there, we all know he's not part of the play. Now, John Cooper can't get that indignant about it because, as New York Islanders fans were happy to point out, here's Tampa with too many men on the ice during Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Final against the New York Islanders. Was it called back? No! Is it a missed call? Even if it is, John Cooper can't keep score. And it's not even just at the NHL level, because I remember, just like Elephants and Pepperidge Farm, 2012 Calder Cup Final between the Toronto Marlies and the Norfolk Admirals. That team was fantastic. A bunch of players on that Norfolk Admirals team that are still with the Tampa Bay Lightning today. They deserved to win the Calder Cup. They were the better team, and they carried a 2-0 series lead into Game 3. However, Norfolk, coached by John Cooper, won Game 3 in overtime with a goal that was offside. It is not a fan theory that it was offside. We know that goal was offside because the American Hockey League actually issued an apology saying they got the call wrong. Did they start the overtime over? Did they? No, I'm not gonna swear. They didn't. Some amazing quotes from that. This is an article that I found from this game that happened 10 years ago. Here it is from CBC.ca. Dallas Eakins and the Toronto Marlies have moved on. That's the message the Marlies coach delivered Friday, hours after the American Hockey League admitted its officials erred in allowing a fluke overtime goal to stand up in Game 3 of the Calder Cup Final. The goal gave the Norfolk Admirals a bizarre 1-0 win Thursday night and a 3-0 series lead over the Marlies. I forgot Ben Scrivens had a shutout going. Oh my goodness. Never forget that the AHL is a developmental league for the referees as well, Eakins tweeted Friday morning. Players and coaches have made mistakes. We all move on. Eakins made no attempt Thursday night to hide his bitter disappointment, saying, I would rather someone take a pair of steel-toed boots and kick me in the nether regions than lose a game like that. And somewhere, boarding a plane bound for Colorado, Nazem Kadri could be seen boarding in a pair of steel-toed boots. Because you're not going to believe who was a member of that Toronto Marlies team in 2012 with 10 points in 11 Calder Cup playoff games. Nazem Kadri. Life's funny. So here's all I know. The goal counted. Should it have counted? I don't know. I wish I knew. I wish John Cooper would tell me. If he's got a legitimate beef, if he's got a point, if he's, dare I say, correct, why didn't he tell us? It's weird. It's really weird. Now, dwelling on this does no good. No good for the Tampa Bay Lightning, because at the end of the day, they're not going to overturn this. They're not. So now, we go to Colorado, where Tampa last lost 7-0, and Tampa has to win 3 straight, 2 of which, if they're lucky, are in Colorado. Admittedly, I am shooting this after I shot the video because there's more news since I shot the video. Statement from NHL Hockey Operations on OT Game 4 winning goal. A too many men on the ice penalty is a judgment call that can be made by any of the 4 on-ice officials. Following the game, Hockey Operations met with the 4 officials, as is their normal protocol. In discussing the winning goal, each of the 4 officials advised that they did not see a too many men on the ice situation on the play. This call is not subject to video review either by Hockey Operations or the on-ice officials. If you're confused, don't worry. That's word salad. That's nothing. They said nothing. Yeah, we know you didn't see too many men on the ice. That's why you didn't call it. If you had seen it, you would have called it, but you didn't see it, so you didn't call it. Was it the right call? That's all we wanted. That's all you had to say. That's nothing. You spent all that time. You issued a statement. You spoke to the guys. All to say nothing. They didn't see it. That's great. Was it the right call or not? At least the American Hockey League had the stones to be like, oh yeah, we got the call wrong in 2012. Come on. Oh my God. That's nothing. That's nothing. As expected, I don't know what I expected. That's nothing. If the Colorado Avalanche are to win the 2022 Stanley Cup, if they are to realize a childhood dream, they have to go through the back-to-back reigning defending Stanley Cup champions in the most desperate position they have ever been in as a team. The Tampa Bay Lightning know what it's like to win the Stanley Cup. They know. They know. Most of the guys on that team know. Even Corey Perry, who could potentially lose his 3rd consecutive Stanley Cup final, he's won the cup in 2007. He knows what it's like. He knows that feeling. He knows how good it is. He also knows how awful it is to lose in the Stanley Cup final. Most of this team's core knows how awful it is to lose in the Stanley Cup final. Because remember, this core, most of it, lost to Chicago in the 2015 Stanley Cup Final. Who were the guys on that team? Stamkos was on that team. Kucherov, Palat, Hedman, Killorn. Keep going. The Tampa Bay Lightning have been, bar none, the best team, easily, no debate, the best team in the National Hockey League for the last 2 years plus. You don't get that crown by accident. You don't get that crown by accident, and you don't hold on to it for as long as they have by accident. The Tampa Bay Lightning, until further notice, are the best team in the National Hockey League, and they're going to be playing at their absolute best, fighting for survival, fighting for their playoff lives in a way they have never done during this run. Colorado has their work cut out for them. So whether it's Colorado going through the most desperate Tampa team we've seen, or the Lightning pulling off a 3-game miracle, this hockey season is going to end with a bang. Lucky us. So, what do you think? Should that goal have counted? What's John Cooper even talking about, and does he have a point? Leave a comment in the comment box down below. Do me a favor, for me, please. Don't be a jerk. Please, don't be a jerk. There's going to be some debate. Don't be a jerk. And if someone's a jerk to you, don't be a jerk back. Break the jerk cycle. Anyway, do it. Don't be a... Stop it. That is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. The Stanley Cup is going to be in the building on Friday.